We got live stream audio is live.
pleasure to be here tonight. I'd like to thank Danny, Bill, and the board for having us here. And joining me tonight on the drums, gentlemen, I first met, I don't think I met you till after you got back from college, right? Yeah, I don't think I met you before you went away. Anyways, gentlemen who grew up in Seattle, went to the esteemed program at Roosevelt High School under Scott Brown, retired. And one of the many fine players to go through that program, one of the swingingest guys, and studied in Boston. And you were at Berkeley, right? At Berkeley School of Music. And wonderful person as well, Mr. Max Holmberg on the drums. Max hosted a session at the Angry Beaver pub for about 10 years. Is it something? Is it?
9 years.
9 years. Okay. Almost 10 years. And, yeah. But it was a lot of fun. And we got a chance. And speaking of that, that's where I met the next gentleman who, were you originally from Chicago?
Born in Chicago.
Born in Chicago. Oh, but grew up in Bend, Oregon. Born in Chicago. How do you end up in Bend, Oregon? I'm going to hear the story sometime. Anyways, wonderful bassist, came in second, right, in the Ron Carter International Bass Competition, and somehow found his way to Seattle. And we met on one of Max's Angry Beaver jam sessions. It was like, decided to do a sextet gig that night. We brought some charts and never met this guy. And all of a sudden, like from the first bar, I was like, oh yeah, this is gonna be fun. And we've been trying to play as much as we can lately. Mr. Trevor Ford on the acoustic bass. Yours truly, Reuel Lubag. Grew up in Kirkland, Washington. Went to Lake Washington High School, Central Washington University, and had the good fortune to be on some named bands over the years. Did the Glenn Miller Band, Jimmy Dorsey Band, stuff like that, and played with Ernestine Anderson and a lot of great vocalists. So it's my chance to finally play some trio stuff. So a lot of the stuff you're going to hear, some of it's original. A lot of it's based on the concepts of Ahmad Jamal, Oscar Peterson, Monty Alexander et al. So that first arrangement was sort of an Ahmad Jamal treatment. That was, of course, The Nearness of You. We're going to continue with an original. This is one I wrote in college when I was very sad after I broke up with my first girlfriend. And it's amazing how you write sappy love ballads after you break up with somebody. But I did it as a project too. I wanted to write a ballad in the style of, Tad Dameron. Thanks. See, he knew what I was thinking. He just wasn't. So this is called Will There Be Love for Me?
Thank you.
Thank you very much. This is really fun to get to play these with these guys. I've had a couple different trios over the years. Way back, I had a band with my friend John Wecon, who I was in college with, and then my friend of mine, Tim Turner, who played for a while, and he's been working on the trains now for about 30 years, 25 years. And then I had a band in the mid-2000s, I guess, with Jeff Harper and Matt Page, and that's where some of these arrangements came from, including this one coming up. This one is one of Matt Page's favorite tunes that he liked to sing and play on the guitar. He was actually a guitar player and trumpet player before he became a drummer. And this is an old standard called Deed I Do. This is influenced by the Oscar Peterson and Ray Brown trios. Thank you. Thank you very much. Let's hear it again for Max Holmberg and Trevor Ford. Yeah, those kinds of arrangements are really fun to do, but they're also very challenging. And sometimes you're just flying by the seat of your pants. So we're going to do another original. This is one I wrote for my friend and mentor, Mr. Monty Alexander. This is called Monty's Mood. Oh, by the way, these songs are available on my album called Premiere, which I believe happens to be in the CD case back there. Anyways, it was recorded with Ed Lutfield and Ben Feldman a few years ago. But if you're interested in copies, they're back there. All right, so here we go. This is Monty's Mood.
Thank you.
All right, thank you very much. I'm going to slow things down. Play a tune that I'd like to dedicate. This is kind of like the Willie Nelson tune, to all the girls I've loved before. Not that that really happened, but this is for all the girls I had crushes on as I was growing up. And this is a rendition of an old song. See if you know what it is. I'll give you a hint. This is the 50th anniversary of this band that released this tune originally. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. You guys know that tune, right? Band celebrating their 50th anniversary this year. It's a four-letter band name from Sweden. Yes. That was Dancing Queen. As a jazz ballad. Yes, folks, I am twisted. But, but you never knew it could be such a nice tune, did you? You'll never think of that tune the same way again. That's for all those girls out there. You had your chance, so anyways. We're going to close this set with an original tune. This is a... So throughout my development as a musician, I always tried to challenge myself to be inspired by compositions I heard, songs I heard, arrangements I heard, to try and come up with something based on something that came before. I'll never forget Lee Konitz said something at Jazz Workshop. It was really funny because Barney Kessel, great guitar player, was trying to tell all these guitarists in the clinic that, yeah, you shouldn't be listening to other people. You need to do your own thing. And Lee goes, excuse me, Barney, I got to disagree with you. And I was coming up in New York. We said we'd save our pennies and we'd wait till the latest Charlie Parker, 78, would come out. And we'd buy our own copy. And we'd learn all of Bird's solos and just play along with the record. And that's how we learned how to play. So you got to sound like somebody first before you can sound like anybody. So that was always the concept behind writing tunes. So like I wrote that that original ballad that was kind of based on Tad Dameron. So this tune is called Luko Luko, which means in for Filipino, it's like means kind of crazy. So like loco, but it's Luko Luko. And this is based loosely on Bud Powell's Un Poco Loco, right? A little crazy. So this is an homage to Bud Powell. So before we play this tune, once again, Mr. Max Holmberg, Mr. Trevor Ford, yours truly, Reuel Lubag. Do want to do a commercial also. Don't forget, Jazz Clubs Northwest is a 501c3 nonprofit. Please consider becoming a member to help support events like this, as well as these jam sessions we host out at different places. I host one a couple times a month at the Crossroads Mall for students from middle school through college. Danny Kolke hosts one here as well. And then I also host one in Edmonds, Romeo's Pizza and Pasta, the third Sunday of the month. That's also sponsored by Jazz Clubs Northwest. So we're going to take a short break after this tune, and then we'll be back for a second set. So hope you'll stick around. Here we go with Luko Luko. Thank you. Thank you very much. We'll be right back.
and Now. This is a tune, it's the title tune of our album that we made, this band and our, and Linda and I, and it's called And Now We're Here. And it's Danny Cokey original.
Thank you.
All right, welcome back for the second set. Once again, my name is Reuel Lubag. Have with me on drums Mr. Max Holmberg, Mr. Trevor Ford on the bass. I'm going to start this second set off. This is an original composition. This was written for a gentleman who is one of the great pianists in jazz history, a gentleman by the name of Cedar Walton. He played with everybody and had such a huge influence as a player and just the sounds that he got at the instrument, just incredible. And I had the good fortune to get to do a transcription book for him for Hal Leonard Publications. So this is something that's kind of based on the vocabulary that he kind of uses. This is called One for Cedar. Thank you. Thank you very much. So recently, the jazz scene's kind of been hit with a couple folks unfortunately passing away, including a legendary saxophonist who I got to work with over the years, Mr. Bill Ramsey. And just the other night, a friend, a vocalist by the name of David Arteaga, passed away at a jam session at Egan's Ballard Jam House. He had performed, and then he wasn't feeling well. And anyways, I'd like to dedicate this next piece. This is on my album. This is based on an old, worship song written by a woman back in 1930-something, 37 or something like that. And it's a, I believe it's from the Psalms, and the verse goes, "The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness, O God." And we'd like to play that for you. This is "The Steadfast Love of the Lord."
Thank you.
All right, here's an original. This is called Dana's Dance. And Dana, I know you're out there somewhere. Oh, well, you're hanging out with your mom and your sister, so never mind.
Thank you. Thank you.
do it again for Mr. Max Holmberg on the drums, Mr. Trevor Ford on the acoustic bass, yours truly, Reuel Lubag. Thank you very much. Don't forget to check out jazzclubsnw.org, 501c3. Make sure you get out and support and become a member to keep events like this going. Thank you very much and have a great evening.